I've got moves you've never seen.
If there were ever an actress who needs no introduction, it would have to be Julia Roberts.
A bag of biscuits, a biscuit mixer, Mr. Mac, get loose.
So not funny. Not funny, and you're also late. And that means you have to get dressed right now.
She has made her career totally her own, never conforming to expectations of what a woman's role on screen ought to be, never falling victim to typecasting, and never repeating herself.
We practically have the beach to ourselves.
So leave what you think you know about Julia Roberts behind and see how she became the Hollywood icon she is today. Julia first stole moviegoers' hearts as the devil may care Daisy in the slice-of-life comedy Mystic Pizza. A memorable turn in Steel Magnolias followed, seeing her hold her own in an ensemble that includes the likes of Sally Field, Shirley MacLaine, Olympia Dukakis, and Dolly Parton. But it was with Pretty Woman that she achieved superstardom. As the quintessential hooker with a heart of gold, Roberts embodied the movie's freewheeling spirit and helped redefine the romantic comedy for the 90s. And for an entire generation of 90s kids, she is, and always will be, the Tinkerbell to Robin Williams' Peter Pan in Steven Spielberg's Hook.
Peter, I want to give you a kiss. No, I mean a real kiss.
From there, she would switch between legal and political thrillers to madcap romances that let her shine as a comedienne.
Want me to turn around or something?
Yes. Not the person I was expecting.
Even in a meta rom-com like Notting Hill, she shows she can confess her love with all the conviction of delivering a dramatic monologue.
So just a girl. Standing in front of a boy. Asking him to love her.
With Steven Soderbergh's Erin Brockovich, she earned her Academy Award for Best Actress, playing an amateur paralegal pursuing action against a utilities company for contaminating the water supply of small-town Hinckley, California.
She had a tumor in her brainstem detected last November. An operation on Thanksgiving shrunk it with radiation after that. Her parents are Ted and Rita. Ted's got Crohn's disease. Rita has chronic headaches and nausea and underwent a hysterectomy last fall. Ted grew up in Hinckley. His brother Robbie and his wife May and their five children, Robbie Jr., Martha, Ed, Rose, and Peter, also lived on the plume. Their number is 454-9554. You want their diseases?
She doubled up again with Soderbergh for Ocean's 11 and 12.
You are up to something, Danny. What? And don't say you came here for me. You're pulling a job, aren't you? Well, know this. No matter what it is, you won't win me back.
Tess, I just came to say goodbye.
She showed her range again, playing photographer Anna Cameron, the unfulfilled partner of Clive Owen's Larry Gray, who succumbs to infidelity in Mike Nichols' adaptation of Patrick Marber's stage play, Closer.
Since my opening last year,
she spent the next decade engaging in duplicity with Clive Owen, again, eating, praying, and loving her way across the globe, and surviving a sweltering August in Osage County until she would strike up her most fruitful collaboration yet with writer-director Sam Esmail.
You were both f***ed up. You were f***ed up.
In Sam Esmail, she found what she calls a creative kinship that reaches fruition in Leave the World Behind, based on the novel by Rumaan Alam.
I can't remember the last time I liked anybody.
Karen coded Amanda Sanford is a character unlike anything Roberts has played before, in a role only she could have done justice. But then again, aren't they all?
So there was a blackout, and you decided to drive all the way out here.
Something is happening, and I don't trust them.